everyone, it's me, Ray Ray Rambles, and today I am going to do a full suit up of my fursuit, General Ulfric, Ulfric the Polar Bear. This suit was made by my good friend Kishalos. I will put a link to his channel in the description. Right now what I'm doing is I am putting the padding inside of his legs because he does have digitigrade legs. Now, the story behind the suit. Basically, the suit was originally of a character named Klondike, who was this blue polar bear. But Klondike got a large redesign. Now he's purple, and he's covered in spots. So the fursuit just didn't look like him anymore. And my friend wanted to sell it for really cheap online, and I quickly snatched him up. And I was thinking, well, I have to make a new character for this guy now. And basically what I did was, I wanted him to be inspired by my favorite video game, Skyrim. And I realized that Ulfric Stormcloak, his, like, mascot or symbol, is a blue bear. And I was like, wow, that is absolutely perfect. And that's where he got his name, kind of his inspiration. And for his character, he is a very, not abrasive, just very show-off-y. He loves drinking. He's basically that crazy guy with the Nordic accent that hangs out at the bar, and he thinks that he's the Dovahkiin, or the Dragonborn, which is the only person who can kill a dragon. He thinks that he's the Dovahkiin, so he wanders around on random mountains trying to find dragons, and he makes up stories about his incredible adventures, and he brings along, like, a plastic axe, you know? He's a very, very funny like that. He likes bragging about his stories that didn't exist. Had to hike up his suit a bit because I'm pretty tall. Putting the padding in correctly. And this next part, I'm going to struggle with my zipper a bit. This is absolutely not Kishalo's fault. Faux fur and zippers just sadly do not mix. And I may have said this before, but as you can see, I'm wearing some face coverings. I just wasn't really ready for a face reveal yet, so I thought that I would cover up and just worry about getting his suit on. So yeah, he used to be named Klondike, and I've only worn him to one convention, and it wasn't for very long. I've worn his head to a couple conventions without the body. His digi legs are not attached, which means that you have to put the padding in yourself. And they're pretty, snug in there, so I can just slip right past them and they won't get knocked around too badly. Now, the suit originally didn't have the white stripes on his, wrists and ankles, but since I am much taller than my friend, I had to, elongate it, so I sewed on those white bits. And I really like what it did to his character. I think it made it look really pretty. Oh, finally got the zipper. Those are his feet. They are outdoor paws. And they just kind of... It's kind of like a sock on the inside. It's like stuffing with foam. And I just... there's like some fabric to separate that from the rest of my feet. He is my only full suit. And I'm going to turn around for this part so that I can put on his head without being disturbed. Now, my friend, he's currently not open for fursuits right now, but I am. So if y'all are interested, I can do that. And if you guys want a fursuit up of my other suits, my partials, please let me know. And I know that I still have to work out the winners for the art contest. I'll do that soon. We can chat so we can get your prizes all sorted out. The paw is always hard to put on if you've already put on the other one. Takes a little bit, so I usually have to have help with this part. Yes, this is as tiring as it looks. It's very exhausting to not even just wear, but put on a full suit. Fix up the padding, and there you go. You are a crazy blue bear boy who wants to fight trees. Trees and deer and whatever he finds out there. Big nubby tail, big boy legs, big paws, big everything. His bandana flopping around. The elusive blue polar bear. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope to do some videos soon. And I'll see you later. Bye-bye.